If you have a big butt like I do.
So who cares? Why not do your own thing and let them say what they want?
What's up, guys, and welcome to another Fashion Nova haul. I know you guys like these clothing hauls, and I had about 90 bucks in a gift card because I returned so many of the long dresses from the last haul, so I figured why not this time we go through the sale items and see what they have in store and how much I can get for around 80 to 100 bucks. Also, as always, you guys on @TaraBabcock on Instagram voted on which ones you liked or thought you wouldn't like. So if you're interested in voting or participating in any way in future videos, don't forget to follow me on @TaraBabcock and @TaraBabcockGames, both of which will be up in whichever corner I decide to put it in, which will also be the corner that I put the polls in when I talk about what you guys voted. So a cool thing about Fashion Nova is that they operate kind of like those really, really low quality sites where they give you crazy promo codes like every 5 seconds. You can get 30% off, and for this particular thing, I got 6 items that were 60% off, and it was like sale 60 that I had to type in. That promo code is probably not still going on, and some of these items might be sold out now, or only have the extra extra large or extra extra small versions left. But nevertheless, I will post the links to everything I talk about and show off in this video down in the description. This is not a sponsored video. I spent my own gift card money on all of these things. The gift card I got because I returned items which I had bought in a previous video with my own money. To date, I've only done 1 sponsored Fashion Nova video, and I wasn't even paid for it. It was like they just sent me product, which was cool. I consider Fashion Nova to be a cheap brand in that it is very low cost, but it's not the worst quality, at least usually. There are some things that are like hit and miss, but they do have a really good return policy, even though you do get gift cards back and there are some things you can't return. And they do it really interestingly, like anything that ends in, for instance, 95 cents or 97 cents or 98 cents, you can't return. But then everything that ends in 99, I'm getting these off, by the way. These aren't the actual things that you can't return. But they do it like that, where it's based on how many cents the thing is listed for. It's weird. So like 1995 might not be returnable, but 1999 would be. Anyway, I digress, kind of. Let's just get into these, huh? You guys wanna see what's going on. You guys wanna see the outfits on me. And you guys wanna see what I bought in the haul, right? Once again, one more mention. If you're on Instagram, instagram.com/TaraBabcock or TaraBabcockGames, you won't be in the dark about what I buy until I post a video about it. This is one of the outfits, by the way. Probably my favorite. So the first thing we have is Eve. Insert clip of me dancing with Eve while I was setting up my set here without makeup on and before I showered after the gym. You guys voted 77% yes and 23% no to Eve. I can see who votes yes and no, not trying to change your answer or anything, but I really should just go through all of the no's, anyone who votes Eve a no, and like block them. Though I'm just not a blocking kind of person. I welcome your dissent, even if it's against the cutest cat in the world objectively and you have no say in it. You're just a bad person at that point. Next we have this set. It's like a workout set. It's from the fitness line that they have there, and I thought I would like it a lot, and I do like the top a lot. It's a cropped hoodie with mismatched colors. One of the sleeves is pink, which I really like. And the top of this is pink, as well as these two little racer lines down the sides. When I felt this, since it's really soft, I thought it would be more elastic, but putting it on, it really does constrain my booty. And I couldn't bring myself to buy any more larges because mediums fit me right now. And anything bigger than a medium won't fit me when I'm losing weight. And I'm doing really good with my diet right now, so I have hope. And I've been hiking a lot, which prompted me to actually put some of the fitness stuff on here because I'm always looking for cute things to hike in because I also post lewd photo sets of my hike and things after I've hiked on Patreon. Yes, I do that. So cute things that I can hike in are definitely a must right now. This one, however, I feel like it's too uncomfortable. The elastic on top is really rigid, which I like because I don't like when it slides down, but at the same time, I feel like it just constrains my ass and doesn't look that great on me yet. I think when I lose weight, or if you're someone who's smaller and you put this on, you're gonna find it to be a little bit baggy, in the legs at least. I like it, but I would say I would probably return it if it didn't come with the cute hoodie, because the cute hoodie is like giving me life right now. I love it. I love cropped hoodies. I usually wear cropped things or belly shirts when I go out to hike because I like to cover as much of my body as possible that's gonna be beaten down by the summer heat. Even though I wear sunscreen, I still worry about getting burnt, so I basically just cover everything up here, the decolletage and everything, when I go out in Vegas because I do not want to age my chest skin or burn myself into skin cancer. It's funny how many skin cancer wards are here. If you go to any main hospital, they have a giant giant skin cancer ward, and you see older people who are clearly Las Vegas natives walking around looking like leather bags. So to avoid that, I actually cover myself up most times if I'm going hiking or gonna be out in the sun a lot in the summer, which is weird. It's very contrary to my style and brand. When I'm home, I feel comfortable. I like to let the titties out and the shoulders out, not so much outside. So anyway, you guys voted this a 62% yes and a 38% no. That's pretty close to 50-50. For those of you who need me to math for you, if you didn't know, which means that a lot of you guys didn't like this, and I guess you guys knew something I didn't, because I thought it was gonna be really cute, form-fitting, and great colors, because it's like a plum pink look. Would you guys change your answer now that you've seen it on me, or do you think it's just as bad or good as you thought it was before? Post in the comments. Also, as you're watching, please let me know which one is your favorite. If you're gonna buy anything, if you've bought anything from Fashion Nova, and of course, if you like any of these things, consult the description. Moving on. The next workout set we have is a three-piece set, and you guys actually had it perform really well in the polls. I think it was 89% yes and 11% no, which will be on the screen over here or over here, whichever. It comes with really soft and a lot thinner fabric leggings with these white designs mid-thigh that also go up on your butt if you have a big butt like I do. And then it comes with a sports bra that is not at all a sports bra. It's basically just like a sports looking bra, or like a sports looking shirt that looks like a sports bra but has no, and I mean no, support. It's just basically a really soft shirt. I would probably, if I was going hiking with this, I would wear a real bra underneath and just kind of mask it as if this is what's giving my boobs the life that they deserve. But yeah, I don't recommend actually using this as a sports bra, especially since it's just so loose. This is a medium. Everything's a medium that I bought except for some smalls, and this is so loose. And then the final part of the set is a dancer top, I think they're called. I forget what they're called. Dancer crop hoodie, dancer hoodie, I don't know. It's basically like a crop top hoodie that literally just shows your titties, which I think is really cool. I would have to slather on repeatedly some sunscreen to wear this outside, but I think it's worth it because it is really cute. Black is really flattering on me. I feel like even the parts that aren't covered when I'm wearing black look more toned. Black is basically more flattering on anyone who wants to look smaller or skinnier or more svelte, but at the same time, it attracts the heat, so you're gonna feel hotter underneath it, which, you know, might be good because you'll sweat more. Or you can contract full-blown heat stroke and die. Be careful out there, guys. I like this one. I give it a yes. I'll definitely be keeping it. I'll probably be keeping the purple set too, because maybe it'll look better or at least be something kind of comfy to lounge around in. And the cropped hoodie is just so cute. The next thing we have here actually doesn't fit me, but I had to try buy it. It's a medium bodysuit, and it has the lowest V-neck I've ever seen in my entire life. Like, I would have to use some kind of wardrobe tape to definitely keep my titties in on this one, but it looks really good, and I took a few pictures maybe for Instagram in it, but I could not clasp these two together at the bottom between my ass cheeks, even if I dug this into my pussy and this into my ass, because it's just like not long enough on me right now. Something I never really thought about is like when you're fat, you have a lot more ass and you have a lot more stomach and stuff. So when you lose weight, even your shoulders and your back lose weight, and you end up having a longer skirt or a longer onesie. And I think this one will fit me when I lose some weight. I like the colors. I know a lot of people probably voted it poorly because of the dumb mustard colors with a little purple thrown in there, but I like this kind of thing. I think it looks really cool. I like horizontal lines. I like that it makes you feel and look more youthful, and I just think it's cute. So I'm gonna keep it because I'm sure it will fit later. If not, I'll just use it as a shirt. I can even like cut it and make it some kind of extra low cut crop top, which is actually kind of a good idea. Because you know, even when I'm skinny, I still have a butt and I still have boobs, and it's probably gonna dig into my asshole. Let's see what you guys voted it. I like it. You guys voted the deep V-striped onesie 76% yes and 24% no. Let me know in the comments if you're a 24%er, because I have an inkling that the reason you don't like it is because of the colors. I like it because of the colors and because that V is a lot deeper in real life. I think you've seen the overlay footage and how deep it is. It's crazy deep. And I like it deep, you know what I'm saying? Moving on. Our next outfit, since I'm doing these in outfit form this time, even though I bought these two separately, is this off-brand scrunchy short, looks like a skirt thing. And then this top, which I thought would be a lot softer and more pliable, but it still actually fits really well and is nice. It's like an off-the-shoulder V-neck shirt with a little scrunchy thing, so you can make it like a full-blown crop top, or you can make it just just basically cover your titties. This is in size medium. I wanted to get it medium just in case it didn't fit, and I'm glad that I did because often the off-the-shoulder stuff kind of cuts into my shoulders. And as I lose weight, that might still be a problem because I do lift weights, so I'm never gonna be like bony there. I think this is flattering. I really like the top either alone or with this, and I'm definitely gonna be keeping both of these. These off-brand things, they're not actually like Fashion Nova brand. This brand is Maze. For some reason, these off-brand things seem less quality than the Fashion Nova brand stuff, but I basically just want this because there's nothing I love more than floral short skirts. They're so cute. Shorts, skirts, not short skirts, but yes, I like them short. I'm also occasionally partial to, as you've seen in the last video haul, maxi dresses and maxi skirts, but they just don't look as good on me. I've also realized that I'm actually really bad at being a girl. Yesterday, I went to get my hair done. I was wearing one of those said maxi dresses, and I just couldn't navigate myself because I'm so used to sitting like this, you know, sitting crisscross and just being a tomboy at heart. So I'm not very good at wearing high heels and long dresses and shit like that. Anyway, love this outfit, will be keeping it, like the short skirts, because they're girly, but they're also easy to navigate for someone like me. Red scrunch top and floral shorts, you guys voted it a 77% yes and a 23% no, which is a little surprising because this is a cute outfit. Next, we have this long dress, which is kind of like a midi dress. It's actually almost a mini dress rather than a midi dress because of how it fits on me, I guess. I don't know if you guys remember, but I do have a set that looks like this that I wore in my last F&M or my upcoming F&M, depending on when this goes up. But this one is a lot thinner fabric. It's ribbed in the normal way you would think it is, not in like the thick knit way, but in like the thin t-shirt way, you know? And I like this one a lot. I think it looks really good on me. It's a bodycon, which right now I'm kind of avoiding, but it doesn't look too bad. And I think it's gonna look really good once I hit the goal weight. And yes, I know you like the way I look now, being thick and all that. And yes, I know that's totally in, and oh my God, you don't think I'm fat, but I don't care what you think. I honestly don't. It's nice when you like things about me, but it ultimately does not change what I want for myself. And I think you guys will like it too, you'll see. I'm not gonna lose my ass or my boobs. Anyway. You guys voted this a 60% yes and a 40% no. And I think the reason that there's so many no's is because if you actually look at it on the floor, it really looks straight down. I think dresses that look straight down look so because they're supposed to fit everyone, but they're tight enough that they're gonna be form-fitting and they're stretchy enough that it's not gonna matter if your hips are bigger and your waist is smaller and your titties are bigger because it's gonna conform because you're basically buying a size that fits you tight enough to do so. Or at least I am. So yeah, I think that's why. The next outfit, I totally understand why this got more no's than yeses, because just sitting there, it literally looks like shit. It's the color of shit. It's very confusing what it's even supposed to be or look like. And yes, you guys did vote it 51% no and 49% yes. Here it is, and it is a shit-colored, stretchy knit outfit, two-piece. I liked it because it has a very, very low cut in the front. It is really stretchy and really soft. I like this fabric a lot. It's a little bit on the thicker side, but not in a way that's gonna make you look bulky. And I dropped it. I like that the elastic is actually sewn on there because when it's not sewn on there, it flips inside. And then you have like a bunch of flipped elastic in there, which is so fucking annoying, let me tell you. And a lot of the Wonderlust collections, I think they're called Wonderlust leggings, right? Those ones, for some reason, just have the elastic just flipping around in the top portion, not sewn on. And for me, every time I sit down, it's just flipping around, folding, and it's awful. So this is a little bit better, but I don't love this set. I just wanted to try it in a different color because I have so many grays and colorful colors. So I try to do things like off the cuff sometimes when I think that the fit is gonna be nice. I would give this like a yes or no. I don't have a strong opinion as to whether it's good or bad. I'm just kind of like, ah, I don't even know if I'll keep it. I'll probably keep it because it was discounted. So why not? It wasn't super expensive. But let me know in the comments if you think it's more of a no than a yes for you, even on my body. I see a lot of you guys saying like, she can make a plastic bag look good, which I appreciate. Thank you very much. But this one, can I make this one look good? The one that was voted by my Instagram followers as 51% no. Post your thoughts. Okay, so We're to the second to last outfit, and this top is actually from the same set as the leggings I'm wearing here. They're a little bit different than the Wanderlust set in that they're not very fuzzy. They're just ribbed t-shirt stuff, kind of like the dress we just talked about recently. But I like this a lot. I think it fits really nicely. You can make it shorter so that it's almost an underboob shirt or a crop top, or you can make it basically not a crop top, but still kind of, because, you know, most things are high-waisted, so you're not gonna see your midriff because you're wearing something high-waisted, probably. I don't know, I just like this top a lot. I think it looks really good without a bra and probably will look good with a bra too. It's got a cute little hood and it's not thick and I like it. The bottom portion of the outfit is from the same company as the other floral shorts, except for this is a large because all they had left was a large, and I honestly don't see the difference in sizing. If anything, this is smaller than the medium, which is really weird and inconsistent, and as you can see, it's from the same company, Maze. So while I like it, it needs to be ironed really bad, and I'm confused as to what the difference is between medium and large because they fit the same, if not the large being smaller. Cute outfit. I don't know if I'll always wear them together. I kind of just bought single pieces and then put them all together in outfits and stuff, but I like them together or apart, and I'll definitely be keeping both of these. You guys voted this outfit a 79% yes and a 21% no. I don't know why it's voted differently from the other set that's kind of like that. Maybe you guys like the hoodie look more than the red salsa bright colored look. Maybe you guys are partial to pink like I am, who knows. Second to last, we have an adorable video clip of Eve just licking herself and rolling around and being adorable like she always is. I actually don't know where she is right now. I think she's asleep on my bed. But anyone who voted no to this, what is wrong with you? What is wrong with you? 100% yes, this should be, I think. And lastly, this outfit that I'm wearing here right now with a ribbed fuck off tank top and the ribbed leggings that belong to the same set as the burgundy top that you saw from the last outfit. You guys voted at 85% yes and 15% no. I think you guys like small black crop tops on me. I got a small in this, and you can see I'm already ripping and stretching out the off, because usually these are so stretchy and I like them to have a little bit of compression on my chest. I like a little bit of compression so that my cleavage looks a little bit better, but this one, it's just not as stretchy. I do like the leggings a lot. They're a lot thinner than the Wanderlust brand, and they have the little elastic only in the top here and built into the top so that it stays up without kind of just falling down. The only kind of falling down I get is it rolling over, but you're never really like trying to find the big long elastic like in Wanderlust and trying to flip it around the right way. Even though I do think this one isn't fastened anywhere, it's so small that it doesn't really matter and it doesn't get flipped around. I like that it has this big top here that compresses you a little bit and makes your shape look nice, and overall I just think it's really flattering, really cute, but I do wish I had gotten this in a medium because my boobs aren't going anywhere, so this is always gonna kind of fit like this, where it's stretching the fuck out of the text. Otherwise, I think it's cute, and this is what I wish people would do if they don't like my content. Just go away. Find content that you like. Stop wasting your time hating on people who make or say things that you don't like. Little PSA there at the end. Anyway, guys, if you liked this, please like the video, subscribe to the channel. Consider joining this channel. You can click the little button next to the subscribe thing, click the bell, whatever the fuck people tell you to do. Make your own decisions. You are your own person. If you want to see more Tara content, you will click that or check back periodically. I upload on Tuesdays and Fridays. It used to be Mondays and Fridays, but now it's Tuesday and Friday. And I love you guys so much. Thank you so much for watching and supporting in any way you want to. Don't forget, all of the links to all of the products in this video will be down in the description. Again, not sponsored, but I do enjoy doing this. I have another one coming soon. This time the items will be sent to me from Dolls Kill. Really excited about that, because they have some wacky fucking pieces on their site and I got to choose. Look forward to that and I will see you in the next video. And lastly, before I go, which one was your favorite? Post in the comments. Bye guys. Okay, now you can fuck off. Fuck off. In the kindest way possible. Bye.